Good morning.
Good morning,
Professor Tsoukassian.
Good morning.
It's a great pleasure for me to have you here and an opportunity to talk a little bit with you. You are a guest at the Martin Luther Universität this semester as a guest professor for Armenian art history. And you come to us from Armenia, from Yerevan State University. You are there the UNESCO chairholder of art history. I would like to invite you to tell me a little bit more about your chair and what you do in Yerevan.
Many years after I have defended my first PhD, I was trying to establish art history chair and art history department at Yerevan State University. But there was always resistance of administration because we had special politic of Moscow administration towards different republics, and only in Moscow and St. Petersburg were chairs of art history and art history departments. Mm-hmm. Not only in university but also in Fine Arts Academy. And also in 68, something was changed and towards Georgia. And in Georgia, they have established two chairs, two departments in their university and in Fine Arts Academy. In our Fine Arts Academy, chair and art history department was organized in 1981. But university was without chair and department. And so it was my dream to do this and to fill this gap. After the collapse of Soviet Union, I have continued my efforts, and suddenly I have received information that we have already National Committee of UNESCO in Armenia, and there is possibility to establish a chair of UNESCO at State University. And I have managed to organize art history chair at university, and meantime art history department. It had happened in 1996. And step by step, the number of students became more and more, and number of professors also. So finally, the situation was so that about 40 people were working at the chair, and about 600 students were. And the situation was this for years, for many years. And about 3 years ago, situation started to change because a great exodus from Armenia started, and many families took their kids and went to different countries. So difficulties started not only for Yerevan State University, but also other universities and institutions. Then the number was minimized of professors till 30 people, and students' number also till 350, around 400. And now we are trying to survive and to preserve these achievements that we have already succeeded to have, and so this is the situation.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a very interesting story you're telling here. So almost single-handedly, it seems you had a vision and made it real that there would be a chair of Armenian art history.
Yes.
And then a whole department developed that came about, and it was a very sizable department.
This was my dream from my student period.
Oh, okay.
Because when I entered university, there were rumors that they are going to open art history department. So I entered university philological department, or as they say in the West, School of Philology, Armenian language and history department, and thinking that after a while I will transfer to art history department. Mm-hmm. But it never had happened, so I have started to do it myself, parallelly to all those subjects that we were passing at our department. So I started to explore also Armenian book illumination, studying those books that were printed in Armenian, Russian, English, mm-hmm. and other languages. Mm-hmm. So when I have finished university, I had a chance to continue my education already in art history. And I have started to attend lectures at art history department of Moscow State University.
Ah, so you trained in Moscow then specifically for art history?
Yes, this was your second possibility for mm-hmm. me. And this way I came in touch with very good professors, mm-hmm. and especially in those who were in Byzantine studies and in Renaissance studies, the world famous professors were working. One of them even is still alive, Olga Popova, a very much respected authority in the field of Byzantine art and also in mm-hmm. Russian medieval art. Mm-hmm. And then there was a chance to defend my dissertation under supervision of Viktor Lazarev, who was the head of chair of Western art at, okay. at Moscow State University, and the scholar with world reputation whose works were translated into numerous languages of the world, including history of Byzantine painting and history of Italian painting, etc. So after a while he passed away, and then I have communicated with another scholar who was expert in especially in Armenian book illumination, Tatiana Izmailova.
Okay.
She was one of important researchers at Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg.
Mm-hmm.
So in this way I have started communications both with Moscow scholars and St. Petersburg scholars.
Mm-hmm.
So these contacts were periodical during years, and always at I had official supervision of Tatiana Izmailova from St. Petersburg, and non-official supervision of Olga Popova from Moscow State University. And then I have defended my first PhD in 1982 at Art History Institute of Georgia in Tbilisi, because there was no council in Armenia at that period.
Mm-hmm.
We were not allowed to have mm-hmm. a council.
Mm-hmm.
And then during years, especially after the collapse of Soviet Union, also council was organized in our art institute at Academy of Sciences.
Let me ask you
yes.
quickly, a council, what exactly is that?
Council is the such a group of people who are sitting during ceremony of defense of PhD, and some of them as opponents are reading the work, and then when the scholar who is going to receive the title, he is representing his thesis, his dissertation, then opponents are talking,
okay.
and after that all the council, about 12 people, they are voting.
Mm-hmm. So that would be the dissertation board?
Yes,
the
it is dissertation board, yeah.
Dissertation committee?
Committee, yeah.
Okay.
They are voting and then decide that they give this title to a young
okay.
person.
Very
so,
interesting.
So this was achievement that we have succeeded to have a chair and to have this board
uh-huh.
to, that our graduates now are able to defend in Armenia.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So that the structures are in place, so that
yeah.
higher education with the possibilities to defend yeah. dissertations in art history is possible in Armenia.
Then in 2001 I have defended second PhD already in Moscow Art History Institute.
So that would be the equivalent of the Habilitation
yeah.
that people obtain
yeah.
in the German-speaking
areas. It is 600
areas.
Pages
yeah.
second
mm-hmm.
PhD.
Mm-hmm.
First PhD is 180 pages.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask you what you wrote your dissertation about, or what your habilitation was about.
My both dissertations were on two different painters of 13th century. First, the dissertation was completely on one manuscript of an outstanding painter of 13th century, Grigor, who illustrated the Gospel of 1232, which is called Tarkman Chats or Translator's Gospel. And this Gospel is completely different from all other all kind of Armenian manuscripts with the style of its illuminations, and it's even different among numerous non-Armenian manuscripts of Middle Ages with its and quite unusual style, especially rendering of faces.
Also with regard to how the artist represents faces, it's very unique.
It's very unique, and another unique feature is that his landscapes are cubistic landscapes.
Oh.
Yeah, and also the symbolic content, theological content, content is very much evident in his presentations of iconographic compositions.
So that would be an artist who would bring theological thinking and spiritual thought into the expression of how the faces and the figures are represented.
It's transformation of text into the language of painting. Especially in the constructions of architectural backgrounds.
Also in those elements.
Yeah, and not
that,
only.
That was your dissertation, your first dissertation.
This was first dissertation.
Let me ask you about the second.
Second dissertation was about number one painter of medieval Armenia, on Toros Roslin, who illustrated numerous manuscripts, but about seven manuscripts have come down to us, and they are preserved in different countries, such as not only Armenia, but also in Jerusalem, also in America, and some also pages, folios I have found. One of them is in Cambridge Fitzwilliam Museum in UK.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the subject of second PhD,
mm-hmm.
and it's something which attracted some painter that attracted numerous scholars. Also non-Armenian scholars, and there is a huge literature about that since the 19th century, and in different languages, different scholars published articles, and both painters, Grigor and Toros Roslin, they are mentioned in all books of general character on Armenian art and Armenian book illumination.
Mm-hmm.
And there are even PhDs defended in the West, in America, also in Austria, on this painter.
Mm-hmm. Specifically Toros Roslin, a very significant figure.
Yes.
Were there special challenges that you had to overcome when you were working on either one of these
there
projects?
There were challenges, especially with beginning of my career, when at university they were not interested to give a job to young scholars.
Uh-huh.
And also they were not encouraging us to publish articles on medieval art, because their theological content and country with communist ideology, which was against religion, with always criticism of religious propaganda. So they were very cautious, and each time they were creating problems when I was taking papers to publish in local academic journals.
Oh, I see.
So I have understood that this way, having problems with job and having problems with publications, I have two options. One of them is continue and insist on my existence in university,
mm-hmm.
and demand a permanent job. A second is to make some PR for myself, and meantime to have a source, a financial source for existence. And I have started programs on Armenian TV and radio on Armenian art of different epochs, and also on world art. And then I have shifted towards 20th century painting also, parallelly working with this manuscript of 13th century, and meantime writing about different painters and being able to publish articles on them. And step by step making these programs and publishing in some popular journals, I made this a kind of propaganda what I am doing.
You build a reputation for yourself that you are not a narrow, theologically spiritual, medieval art historian, but that you can command the much wider scope of Armenian art, basically.
Meantime, I was reviewing certain publications on Armenian art in different languages that were appearing in other countries, in Europe and in America. Mm-hmm. And also in Russia. Mm-hmm. So this was also from other side showing that there is permanent interest toward Armenian art in different countries, that it is not just you know, interesting for Armenian scholars or Armenian society, but also there are people who are busy with exploration of Armenian art in other countries.
Allow me to ask a little bit more about that. I have heard that you are quite engaged in developing projects or trying to pursue locating, finding, and showing their relevance in various areas of Armenian art, artifacts, manuscripts, or objects in other places. Could you tell me a little bit more about some of your projects that you do in order to show that Armenian art, in a wider sense, is really an element, a very important element of world culture? I would quickly capture in that way, but...
When I was reviewing books on Armenian book illumination that appeared in other countries, I paid attention that they are appearing publications on Armenian illustrated manuscripts in Walter's Art Gallery in America, in Baltimore, and also on the collections in Mkhitarist collections of Mkhitarist congregations in Venice and and Vienna, also on collections in Isfahan, Iran, and in British Library and in Jerusalem. So when I was reviewing all these books, I step by step I understood that there are so many things that are in different countries that if other scholars already started the exploration of these artifacts, so it's necessary to follow them, to continue, and to do what they haven't succeeded to do yet. Mm-hmm. So this way, when already I was working with my colleagues and former students who graduated art history department, I have decided to start exploration of Armenian artifacts in Romania, as there was a big community during centuries, and this number of Armenians was increased after genocide of 1915-1923. So many Armenians moved to Romania and took with them many artifacts. And so in Armenian churches in Romania, up to now, nobody started systematically all these artifacts. Mm-hmm. So about 6 years ago, we started visits with a group of scholars, my colleagues and former students, and started step by step to explore what is preserved in the Museum of Cathedral of Armenian Church in Bucharest, and in other churches near the border of Ukraine and Moldavia, and also in Transylvania, which was populated by Catholic Armenians.
Oh, okay, so this also gives you opportunities to go beyond more narrow confessional boundaries.
Right. And Armenian Society of Romania, which is very active, and also the Bishop of Armenian Church, Head of Armenian Church in Romania, they have supported us. And then we started communications with other institutions in Romania also, and were able to get some grants for our young scholars who were already involved in exploration of artifacts. New Europe College of Bucharest gave grants for 6 months for each scholar. And then also the Romanian Academy of Sciences also was interested in work which we are doing. And we, with Academy of Romania, succeeded to have two conferences on Romanian-Armenian historic and artistic relations. Okay. International symposiums that scholars not only from Armenia but also from other countries participated. But we were the locomotive of this. Because we were a group, working with group, all group was participating in that. And scholars, certain scholars from different countries were coming and joining to this nucleus.
So you brought in experts in manuscripts?
Manuscripts, on textiles, on silverwork, on icons, on art. Textiles, generally speaking. So these were experts, and on illustrated manuscripts, of course. So this work was started, and also many artifacts were very professionally filmed. And
we so are going
now.
Yeah,
now we are going to publish one volume, and it will be interesting if also other volumes will follow to this work.
Okay, so I see that you went to larger institutions that were already known. You took note of what is there. And then you realize that in some particular regions, there is also quite a wealth in the end of artifacts that are not well documented. And then you established a group and found support from various different ends, from the church, from the academy.
Also Ministry of Culture of Armenia.
Oh, also from Armenian
supported
side.
And also Ministry of Affairs of Youth also supported with travel travel expenses which given by these institutions. And meantime, we have succeeded to get some financial support also from Committee of Science of Armenia.
Okay.
So this was done during all these years, and parallelly we started exploration of Armenian art collections in Isfahan in Iran.
Ah, so there would be another site that you have now identified.
This is parallelly started with some other members who were not included in a Romanian group. And we started already the exploration of manuscripts there, and also as we have contacts with scholars in different countries, we have succeeded to organize the visit of one of experts, museum experts in St. Petersburg, to go to Isfahan to organize the exposition of the museum of church in Isfahan, cathedral. Next to cathedral, there is a museum. That exposition was organized in 1933, 32. So it's old exposition.
So the permanent collection and the exhibition that results from that.
And collection was expanded since then.
I see.
So there was necessity to organize in scientific form. And this lady was experienced in that. She's Armenian and fluent in Armenian, able to communicate with local Armenian community leaders. So she worked there day and night and organized this. But also our members of our church, they have made certain trips to there, and they have received for this some financial support from Galus Gulbenkian Foundation in Lisboa. And some grant which is called ANSEF, Armenian National Scientific Educational Foundation gave it. And so there is going this process now.
And in this case there is
two different directions, Romania and Iran.
Yeah, and then in Iraq or Iran, Isfahan, I see that there is a benefit also for the wider community resulting from your work when the collection in the museum is updated and brought to a more modern or a richer status, the local population or whoever wants to visit has a benefit of seeing a broader and more diverse picture of the art.
Both communities in Romania, both Armenian communities in Romania and in Iran are very much enthusiastic about this, and they are very happy that periodically come already people from Armenia for exploration of those artifacts that they have.
Uh-huh. Very good. Do you have an idea about another project like that that could happen in another location? Do you already have explored possibilities?
You know,
it seems like you have established a pattern that has proven itself at least two times already and could be transferred.
You know, there is a started work of exploration of artifacts in Ukraine, on the former territories of Poland. And as there are only three scholars working this in different countries, so their interests are not completely on art history, but also on historiography, also on generally history of Armenian community. So for encouraging their work and for bringing more scholars to this field, we started to cooperate with them, and meantime to make possible that they will represent their work in other countries of Eastern Europe. They participated in Romanian symposiums that we have organized with the Romanian Academy of Sciences. Also, we are working with Polish scholars. Especially,
so Poland would be a further location.
We know that there are hundreds and hundreds of artifacts in Polish museums in different cities, and certain Polish scholars, especially young scholars, they are interested on these things, but they need expertise of other experienced scholars from Armenia because they don't know Armenian art so much.
Mm-hmm.
But as this movement is started already, exploration of artifacts in Ukraine, exploration of Armenian art, generally speaking, in different countries, on Armenian collections there. So this is encouraging, this work. And also the community of Armenians was increased in Poland during the last 30 years.
Okay.
And numerous Armenians went from Armenia to Poland, and they are cooperating also with universities, for instance, with Jagiellonian University in Krakow, or Cardinal Wisniewski University in Warsaw. So these two different groups of scholars in both the Polish institutions, they are organizing conferences, symposiums, lectures, and they have the Center of Armenian Culture in Warsaw.
Mm-hmm.
They are publishing one periodical, the Herald of St. Gregory, Poslanec Sv. Gregorce, and it is in Polish and in Armenian. So we are trying to somehow encourage this work there, and participated in their symposiums, and also collaborated with articles in their scholarly journals.
Mm-hmm.
And so the Polish Armenian community, as it was very active during centuries in Middle Ages, it produced numerous things that are scattered in different centers. But meantime, numerous artifacts from Armenia went to Poland during centuries with those Armenians who were living in Poland. And this way, a lot of things are accumulated in Poland too. And we are interested also in what is preserved in other countries of Europe, but first of all, Eastern Europe.
Okay, so a very strong focus of your
work
and of your interest
because
is on Eastern.
Former Austro-Hungarian Empire, it was including inside of it part of Poland, part of modern Ukraine and Moldavia, or Hungarian.
Mm-hmm.
So we are interested in all those parts of former Austro-Hungary where Armenian communities. And if there were Armenian communities, so there are Armenian artifacts too.
Okay. Now, one could discuss exactly where Germany belongs, if it is to be sided to the west
Eastern,
a little bit more,
it
but
has
it has both
Eastern
sides.
Eastern side,
so I'm curious, you have been a guest professor at Martin Luther Universität for a few weeks now. Do you see potential that a project could be done? Is there Armenian art also that found its ways to Germany? Are there at least pieces that you maybe have found?
Yes, I have found certain pieces, and my intuition says that many other pieces will come after that. So nothing is coincidental.
Okay. So we will look forward to further progress
we
that your
be
work
positive.
Makes, yeah. And maybe we can find some ways to
sure.
collaborate with you and
I hope.
Engage in this project, because what you have set up is very impressive.
Yeah.
The network, and then also from the beginnings, how you followed your dream, basically.
Yeah.
I want to thank you for your time and for sharing with me.
Thank you, and I am grateful for
steps in your life.
I am very grateful for the invitation to have a chance to deliver lectures in your university. And also thank you for this interview.
Thank you very much, Professor.